This is the differential voltage probe. It's used in our experiments involving electricity, so it's designed to measure potential difference in a circuit. The maximum range for this sensor is plus or minus 10 volts. We actually say plus or minus 6 is probably the operational range you'd want to use. So it's designed for battery and bulb experiments. If you want to use voltages higher than that, we do have a 30 volt voltage sensor, so it's our higher volt voltage sensor. So I'm going to use this with our Vernier circuit board today and measure some potential differences across some resistors in the circuit. And to be able to do this, I'm going to plug in my voltage probe there, my differential voltage probe. And when we do this, it comes up here. I'm getting a slight reading there. It's close to zero. One of the things that I can do if I want to is I can actually zero a sensor. So if I zero the sensor, it should be giving a value close to zero there. It's oscillating a little bit. And what I want to do is I have two resistors here in series, and I'm going to measure the potential difference across each of them and then measure the potential difference across the two in series. And it should be such that the two in series should add up to the potential difference across there and be at least be close to it. So I need to turn this on. And what I'm going to do is actually have this collect a graph as we do this. To begin collection, I need to press my collect button here. Goes to the graph. And now I'm going to measure the potential across the total circuit. Then I'm going to move to where I measure the potential across one of the resistors. And then I'm going to take it off and switch it to the other resistor. And then take it off completely. So we have our data. And at this point, we might want to analyze this. And what I would say is that it looks like that these peaks are about half the height of that, and I would hope it would be, because it should be that the sum of the voltages, voltage drops around the circuit, should add up to the total voltage drop there from the voltage source. And so to analyze this, the easy way might be just to examine a value up here. And so I'll tap there on the graph, and I get my potential of about 3.06. I'm just kind of a random value there. So it's a little over 3. If I go over here, I get that to be 1.48, close to 1.5. If I look at that one, it ends up being about the same thing, so it's close to 1.5. So if I add 1.5 to 1.5, I get about 3. So the sum of the voltage drops do add up to the total drop across the circuit. So you would use this sensor in labs like this, which might be an Ohm's law lab, series and parallel circuit labs. It's nice for RC time constant labs. So really any lab that involves the use of electricity with a battery and bulb set, this one is very useful for that.